Today, I'm going to attempt something new. I'm going to try to mix a track in a GarageBand with only using the stock plugins that come with GarageBand. And what I hope to prove is that it's the ear, not the gear. But we'll see that in the end. I also don't know the answer yet. What I do know is that this is going to be a challenge for me as well. The track that I'm using is a track from a fellow YouTuber called GarageBand and Beyond. Lewin is his name, and he actually did an interview with me, which you can find on his channel. I'll just link his whole channel over here, and at the end of the video I will probably link to the original song. So I have his project over here. What I did to this project is I removed everything from the masterbus because there were non-stock plugins on the masterbus. All the other stuff I kept intact, so I'm actually going to adjust his mix. So at the top of the session we have the vocals. At the sides of the sessions we have wooden panels, then we have a guitar, a flatpick guitar, a mandolin, we have an organ, Hammond thingy, a piano, we have drums, then we have some, what is it? Then my blood flows. Electric guitar, some clean echo stuff, what do we have more? Yeah, cool. And then. Cool. So what I want to start with is with muting the vocals. Now, I'm not a GarageBand professional, so maybe there's a quicker way to do this. Maybe I'm doing a lot of things in a way that it's not supposed to happen. But deal with it. It's now only about mixing. First, let's take a look at the drums. Now, the thing with GarageBand is it all comes from one channel. So, I can adjust some things, that's the cool thing of working in GarageBand. Good! And I would actually love to... separate them. I think that will be difficult. Yeah. No, no, we're going to do it without separating it. Let's check the channel EQ. Woohoo! Channel EQ. Yeah, I can also do it like this, right? Yeah, okay. Now, how are we going to do this? Cool, cool, cool. A bit smaller. Can we adjust the Q factor or not? Yeah, we can. This is difficult. Why did he make this? I don't care. Is there a way to adjust the cue? No. Oh, good. That's the cool thing about GarageBand, you can actually fiddle with the original sound. No. Mm-hmm. more compression on here. This compressor doesn't make it simpler for the users. Like, the GarageBand is supposed to be simple, but this is not a simple compressor. Alright, next thing is going to be, so the piano and the rock organ. So first the piano. Now what I want to do on the EQ with this piano thing. Alright, then organ. Yeah, come on, come on. Like that, yeah. Shit, there's automation in there. Oh wait, maybe I have a gain somewhere that I can... Yeah, EQ, just the EQ gain. Yeah, just do this. Alright, the intro starts with a guitar. Now this guitar is recorded with a DI, I think? Which is not the best ID. yeah, let's see how to fix that. Compressor, yeah, channel EQ. First let's solo this thing. Oh shit, it's not fab filter, it's not fab filter. Oh wait, this is how I disable everything, okay. First bell filter. Bit of high. You can actually hear him singing, I think. And then middle filter. Thank you. Ja. Oké, mandolin. Ah, de piano. De piano is still not... No. Going to do the piano differently, of course. No. Good. Not sure if I'm actually liking this. What happens here? Okay, lead vocal.
Amongst those stars, my dreams start running wild. I feel like I have found a way to crack a brand new smile. And now I know that my blood flows. I can feel it in my heart.
The trick I'm doing is I'm using less threshold and more ratio on the vocal.
The journey it will start.
And then, because it's got two channel EQs on here, let's disable all this stuff. Only keep that filter active. Let's EQ on the second one and let's remove all of this. And let's listen to this in solo.
My dreams start running wild. I feel like I have found a way.
Ooh, now you hear the quality of this EQ.
To crack a brand new smile.
Or the way it's recorded or the microphone or whatever.
And now I know that my blood flows. I can feel it in my heart. And here I'm walking at 2 a.m. The journey it will start.
Okay, let's listen to this in the whole mix.
Somewhere up there, amongst those stars, my dreams start running wild. I feel like I found a way to crack a brand new smile. And now how I know that my blood flows. I can feel it in my heart.
It's a, it is indeed a difficult vocal to EQ.
The journey it will start. I used to think that she was the only, but now I know today it's gonna be better. It's gonna get better, baby.
Okay, let's take a look at this, because here's something interesting going on. Let's first do the first one. So this is a stereo one, two of the same ones.
Make me lonely.
But I would pan them like 100% left and right. Because nobody's going to hear this difference on these vocals in this, you know, all the instruments that are going on. So I'm keeping them as wide as possible. People call me crazy for that, and I have no problem with that whatsoever. All right, like this.
Make me lonely. Ooh. I used to think that she was the only, but now I know today.
Ah, the main vocal is still difficult.
One who used to make me lonely, she finally fades away. I used to think that she was the only, the one who used to make me lonely, she finally fades away. I used to think that she was the only, but now I know today.
Okay, let's see how the song continues.
It's gonna be better. It's gonna get better, baby. The one who
A lot of volume automation on the channels is not really necessary anymore.
The sun,
probably on how hard I'm squeezing stuff, but
sun shines through. I can feel it on my skin. A little patience, a lot of trust, and my journey will begin. It's not my first. Won't be my last that I walk that lonely road, but I'll keep working, I'll never give up.
Right, I'm actually really interested in his own mix. Before I'm going to do that, here are a few things to think about in GarageBand. Well, when you want to do this in GarageBand, it's actually pretty much doable. I actually like to say that it won't necessarily become much better on analog gear. There will be a difference, of course. There will be a huge difference because of the approach. I'm not saying that it won't sound good when you do it in GarageBand. So, Neumann for sale? No, not that. I won't sell my analog equipment. You can stack the whole room full of gear, but if you don't know how to mix, it isn't going to make a difference. So a few things about GarageBand is I found it difficult to gain, but that's maybe because all those automation lanes are already in here and that I want to respect the automation, but on the other hand, I need to change the automation because I mix it different. I also find different is the difficult is the way the compression works in here. Where is it? It's the compressor. Well, you have this thing over here. On some channels, you don't have it, and you only get these controls, and that's a bit pretty basic. And gain staging is a bit difficult, but that's also because of the automation. Anyway, let's see what I did compared to what Lewin did. So first, we start with the Lewin mix. Somewhere up there, amongst those stars. Okay, now my mix for the same part. Somewhere up there, amongst those stars. So different energies, if I can call it like that. I do like the subtlety of his intro. I feel like I have found a way. His mix. To crack a brand new smile. And now I know. Okay, my mix. That my blood flows. I can feel it in my heart. And here I'm walking at 2 a.m. The journey it will start. A lot of balancing differences. There's someone out there who wants me to. She's finally within range. The one who used to make me lonely. She finally fades away. I used to think that she was the. Yeah. Difference is also in vocal balance and vocal effects. It's gonna be better. It's gonna get better, baby.
Sunshine's through. I can feel it on my skin.
That's the difference. If you ask me, can I mix a track like a production ready for mastering in GarageBand without any external plugins? I would say yes, you're perfectly fine as far as GarageBand on the Mac goes. I don't know how it is on iOS. I actually do not have an iPad, contrary to what most people think. If GarageBand on the iPad is the same, then yeah, you can perfectly mix a song in GarageBand. Now, would I recommend it? I think if you actually use Logic to stay in the same like Apple ecosystem, and it gets easier because you have a bit more controls. But maybe that's also because I look at it as an audio engineer. If you're not an audio engineer, then maybe GarageBand is actually easier. That's confusing, right? Anyway, I really want to thank Lewin from GarageBand and Beyond a lot for, you know, handing out this project to me and just say like, you do everything you want with it. Go check out his channel and check out his videos. Check it out. And what I will link in the corner over here is the original is going to get better on his channel. Now, let me know what you think in the comments down below. Also, let me know what you think of his mix and my mix. And feedback is always good. And I would really like to know which mix you prefer, because I made a whole different taste, actually. That's actually what you hire a mixing engineer for. You hire him for his taste, not for his skills. I mean, the taste is more important. If a mixing engineer has good taste, then it's good. Anyway, if you want to support me, then check out my Patreon campaign, which I will link over here. There will be some bonus content coming soon on there, so check it out. Also, if you want to watch more of my videos, then I will link one of them over here. If you don't want to watch them, then unsubscribe and bye. For everybody that watched, thanks a lot for watching, keep pushing, and bye-bye.